On the vast expanse of the North Shore that is the Great Marsh, a small team is at work, busy making what they hope is enduring change. Wide tires tread lightly as one man pushes a simple mower, trimming the tall grasses. Jeff Wilson is harvesting salt hay, which his team will then use to heal deep ditches that have weakened this important ecosystem.
It's a farmer's ditch. It was probably dug in the 1800s.
Wilson owns Northeast Wetland Restoration. He was hired by the trustees of reservations and other partners to restore portions of the Great Marsh. His team is mending up to 50% of the centuries-old farm trenches. Russell Hopping, lead coastal ecologist with the trustees, says a troubling forecast inspired the organization to think hard about lasting solutions for thousands of acres of coastline.
The projected sea level rise was going to be impacting all of our coastal properties. The results indicated that our beaches and our salt marshes were two of the most at-risk habitats. We don't have a lot of time. Our modeling tells us by 2070, we could see most of this marsh being flooded on a daily basis.
At risk, a crucial habitat for creatures of all kinds.
Salt marshes are very important for a variety of reasons. They can buffer coastal communities from storm surge. They also, by the way, are incredibly useful at storing carbon. So as we think about climate change, salt marshes store more carbon than forests do.
Hopping explains the marsh is at risk of sinking because of the old farmers' ditches. They allow too much air to reach the base of the marsh, causing decomposition. And in areas where the ditches clog, the marsh gets waterlogged, harming root systems.
So we're standing right here, and all these red lines are the old embankments that the farmers created.
To nudge nature back to its original state, grasses are mowed next to the ditches being healed.
Once that grass is cut, then it is moved with a small hay rake into each ditch. It is secured with twine and wooden stakes to keep it from floating away with the incoming tides so that it can sequester all of that sediment that comes in every single tide.
We bring the groundwater up to just below the growing root zones of the plants. And that allows the plants to grow faster. They don't have to make up for that lost ground.
This is the third and final year of restoration on this section of marsh at Old Town Hill in Newberry. Already improvements are visible.
We're seeing the marsh where it was waterlogged, we're seeing it dry out. We're beginning to see salt marsh sparrows move into these places where we know they were not nesting because it was too wet. We're seeing less mosquitoes and mosquito breeding habitat. And we're seeing high marsh plants recolonize and increase in abundance.
The salt marsh sparrow in particular is considered a herald of success or failure. The bird only lives in salt marshes. Population has been declining every year. Hopping hopes to reverse that trend.
The more species we have and the healthier the populations, the more resilient an ecosystem is. It's really about biodiversity.
There along the North Shore, proof people are part of the solution, healing what's broken. On the Cape, cleaning beaches by hand and cultivating creatures that clean our waters. Imagine if we all pledge to do our part. I'm Erica Tarantell. That's Chronicle for tonight. Thanks for watching. Good night.